I think most of you guys watching my YouTube videos are using a Xiaomi phone, and you know how MIUI behaves when it comes to third-party launchers. You cannot use navigation gestures, and that's really annoying. In this video, I'll try to show you what is the exact issue behind this, and I will also show you how to fix this or how to make some adjustments to get a better experience. I have two devices here, one is Vivo and the other is a Xiaomi phone. If you go to settings and search for navigation, you will get different results on both these devices. On Vivo phone, system navigation is a separate component, but on a Xiaomi device, system navigation is integrated inside home screen, that is Xiaomi's default launcher. So whenever you try to install a third-party launcher on a Xiaomi device and set it as a default option, it creates an issue because Xiaomi's operating system recognizes it as a separate UI that automatically leads to navigation gestures getting disabled. I will show you one more thing here. This is a rooted Xiaomi device. If I delete the system launcher and then go to settings and search for navigation, it is no longer there. Gestures are gone, and that's what is happening here. If you really want to fix this issue, there are quite a few options available out there, but only two of them work properly. First one and the easiest, flash a custom ROM. And this is the only legit method available out there. Legit in the sense that it does not require more time and energy. I know some of us don't want to do all this custom ROM stuff, but it is the best solution available out there. You are going to find a lot of YouTube videos on how to flash a custom ROM. I have also posted a couple of them on my channel. You can go ahead and take a look, and I'll also place some links in the video description. You need an unlocked bootloader and a custom recovery to flash a custom ROM. I know some of us do have some questions about custom ROM security, but you should also see the reputation of MIUI and how they collect your data. And you would also notice that there have been no security issues with custom ROMs till date. So yes, custom ROMs are as safe as the default ones that come with your phone. If you still have trust issues, you can go with Lineage OS or Pixel Experience because they have been out there like for ages. Now let's move to the second option, and this one is tedious. Root your phone. Rooting a Xiaomi phone is not that hard, but the steps you need to follow after you root your phone are very complex. Anyways, I'll show you the exact steps to enable navigation gestures on a rooted Xiaomi device. Step 1 is to download a bunch of modules and APK files on your phone, and I'll place all the download links in the video description. If you are rooting your phone from MyDisk, then step 2 is to open MyDisk, go to settings and enable Zydisk. Step 3 is to flash a module called LSPosed. On MyDisk, go to modules, select LSPosed from your storage and flash it. And when this is complete, reboot your phone. Then you need to install an application called MIUI Gesture. Well, the name is kind of interesting here. When the installation is complete, open LSPosed from the notification bar and enable MIUI Gesture, and make sure both system launcher and system UI is checked. Step 4 is to install Fluid Navigation Gestures from Play Store or APK Mirror. Open the application and give all the necessary permissions like drawing or other applications and accessibility permissions. And when that is done, go to Application Information, enable Auto Start and disable all the battery restrictions if that's not already done. Step 5 is to reboot your phone, and you are done. Now you should be able to use navigation gestures with any third-party launcher of your choice. You can also make some adjustments by using the default MIUI launcher with gestures or any third-party Android launcher with navigation keys. I have got some tips for you to make your experience better with MIUI launcher. Select a minimal theme and combine it with other themes. In order to make your home screen or application drawer look clean, it is better to choose a simple theme. Xiaomi Theme Store has some pixel themes that you can try, and I will also leave some other names in the video description, so you can search for them easily. Xiaomi Theme Store also gives you an option to customize the themes, where you can combine different elements to make your own theme. For example, you can select icons from one theme and combine them with other themes. And I think this is one of the best ways to customize a Xiaomi phone overall. Try to use the combination of folders and single applications on home screen, and this is definitely going to make your home screen better. For the application drawer, remove or disable all unnecessary things like application suggestions or placing new applications on home screen. I also do not like application categories, but it might be a personal choice. Instead, you can use a scroll bar to make things easier. And finally, stay updated with the latest version of Xiaomi Launcher. You might not get timely updates on your phone, so it is better to visit APK Mirror website and grab the latest version of Xiaomi Launcher to enjoy the early features. Also wanted to let you know that there are some other methods that can be helpful with these navigation gestures, like using an application called LADB. I tried it, but it did not work. If you want any additional information about this application, I will leave some links in the video description. You can go ahead and check them out. Now, before we end this video, I thought I will also include a quick guide on how to root any Xiaomi phone running on MIUI. And please note that your device bootloader needs to be unlocked before you start with all this rooting process. And please remember to enable developer options as well as USB debugging on your Xiaomi phone. After your device bootloader is unlocked, you can download and extract platform tools on your PC. Now download TWRP recovery for your device. Download two copies, one on your PC and the other one on your phone. and try to keep all the downloaded files on your phone's external storage. On your PC, rename the recovery file to TWRP. Copy and paste it in the extracted platform tools folder. Download the MyDisk APK file on your phone and make sure to download it from GitHub. Don't use any other source. Make two copies of MyDisk on your phone and change the extension of one of the MyDisk files to .zip. Take your phone to fastboot mode and connect it to your PC. Open platform tools folder and type cmd in the address bar to bring command prompt. Type the first command, that is fastboot space devices, and press enter to confirm that your phone is detected through fastboot mode. Type the second command, that is fastboot space flash space recovery space twrp.img, and press enter. This will flash the recovery file on your phone, but this is not the permanent installation. Type the second command, that is fastboot space boot space twrp.img, and press enter. This will take your phone to recovery mode. When the phone is booted to recovery, tap on install, tap on install image, select TWRP recovery file from your phone storage, and tap on recovery option and swipe to confirm flash. And when the flash is complete, you can go back to the main interface. Tap on install again, select MyDisk zip file and swipe to confirm flash. And when this is complete, you can reboot to system and open your file manager. Tap on MyDisk APK file and install it. And that's it, your phone is rooted now. And that was the video, guys. Let me know in the comments if you are going to try any of these methods to fix the navigation gestures. And if you have any questions or queries, you can drop a comment and I'll be happy to reply. Thank you so much for watching. I'll see you in the next one.